Sir, please start.
Good morning, all of you. Good morning, all the students. Good morning, principals, teachers, and all the persons who are watching this session. Now we have the webinar session from the subject Commerce and Accountancy. The topic is partnership accounts, in that admission of a partner. This is our sixth session from this topic. In the today's session, we are going to learn about the capital adjustments is based on the new profit sharing ratio. Now this session is going to be handled by V. Premlata, PGT Commerce from TSMS Bullaram, Jinnaram, Sangareddy District. Students, please listen the session carefully, and this is very important question, and might be this adjustment will appear in your board exam. And as you all know that the weightage for this problem is 20 marks. So listen it carefully and solve the task given by the teacher. Now, finally, over to you, madam. Please.
Good morning, sir. A wonderful morning to all the principals, teachers, students, and all the viewers. I am V. Premlata, PGT Commerce from Telangana Model School, Bullaram, Jinnaram. The subject coordinator for second year accountancy and commerce is Mr. Muhammad Riyazuddin, sir, principal, TSMS, Jarasingham. Today I am here to discuss on the chapter admission of a partner for intermediate second year students. Children, in the new textbook it is chapter number 5, but in the old textbook it is chapter number 6. Okay, this is sixth session. Already on this chapter we have already covered 5 sessions. This is the last session in admission of a partner. So by the end of this chapter, what you will be learning? Treatment of goodwill, when goodwill is created or valued in the books at full value. Already in fifth session also we discussed on this topic, when goodwill is created and valued in the books at full value. Now adjusting the capitals of partners on the basis of the new profit sharing ratio. So the new partners, the capitals will be adjusted based on their new profit sharing ratio. Till now, whatever we have seen, their capitals are based on their old profit sharing ratio. But in this session, we will be seeing how to adjust capital of the partners based on their new profit sharing ratio. And you will be able to prepare ledger accounts like revaluation account, cash account, goodwill account, general reserve account, capital account, and opening balance sheet of the new partnership firm. What are the accounts to be prepared? You will be preparing revaluation account, cash account, goodwill account. If general reserve account is given in the closing balance sheet, then that general reserve account will be preparing partners capital account and balance sheet. These are the accounts you will be preparing. Now this is a specimen of revaluation account. In each and every session I am showing you this revaluation account specimen. Whenever a value of an asset increases, you will be writing on the debit side, credit side of the revaluation account. Whenever any value of the asset decreases, you will be writing on the debit side of the revaluation account. Revaluation account is like a nominal account, and it takes the rules of nominal account. Debit all expenses and losses, credit all incomes and gains. So if the value of an asset decreases, you will be writing on the debit side. If the value of an asset increases, you will be writing on the credit side of the revaluation account. The vice versa happens with liabilities. If the liability increases, it is an expense for you. So it will be debited on the revaluation account, debit side. If the liability decreases, then it will be written on the credit side of the revaluation account. So provision of bad debts, that is for anticipated loss on debtors to be created, that should be taken or written on the debit side of the revaluation account. If provision for bad debts is not required, then you will be writing on the credit side of the revaluation account. If your credit side total is, when you are balancing the figures, if your credit side total is more, you will be having profit. If your credits debit side total is more, then it will be loss. So profit or loss, it should be transferred to are credited to partner's capital accounts, profit or loss. You have to transfer it to partner's capital accounts. We will understand this with an example. Adjustment of capitals based on new profit sharing ratio. So on this topic, we will be solving the problem. How to adjust partners' capital accounts based on new profit sharing ratio. Okay, Rajesh and Ramesh are partners sharing profits and losses in the ratio of 3:1. So what is their old profit sharing ratio? 3:1. Who are the two partners, old partners? Rajesh and Ramesh are the two partners who are sharing their profits in the ratio of 3:1. Their balance sheet as on 31st March 2020 was as under. Sundry creditors, general reserve. So here general reserve is given. So we will be preparing general reserve account. That is, general reserve should be credited to old partners in their old profit sharing ratio. General reserve account, you have capitals of Rajesh and Ramesh. Next, cash account, debtors account, stock account, land and buildings account, furniture account. So what are the adjustments we will be seeing? We will see the adjustments now. They decide to take Mr. Suresh into partnership for 1/5 share in the future profits on the following conditions. So Mr. Suresh is a partner who is admitted into the partnership firm, who will be sharing 1/5 share in the future profits. So what is the new partners, that is Mr. Suresh, share in future profits? It is 1/5. Suresh should bring rupees 20,000 towards capital. So how much amount Suresh should bring as capital? He should bring rupees 20,000 towards capital. Now depreciate furniture and stock by 10%. Depreciate furniture and stock by 10%. So whenever a asset is depreciated, the value will decrease. That means it should be written on the debit side of the revaluation account. So depreciation on furniture, to furniture, you will be writing on the debit side of the revaluation account. To stock, you will be writing on the debit side of the revaluation account. Land and buildings are to be appreciated by 20%. So land and buildings value is appreciated, that is increased. Whenever land and buildings value is increased, you have to write on the credit side of the revaluation account. Goodwill of the firm is valued at rupees 8,000. So whenever a partner who is admitted into the business, if he is not able to bring goodwill in cash, then the goodwill will be created or raised because it will be having some value. So that should be shown. So this goodwill of the firm is valued at rupees 8,000. Create a provision for bad debts at 5% on debtors. Whenever any provision is created, you have to write on the debit side of the revaluation account. Capital accounts of the partners to be adjusted in cash on the basis of the new profit sharing ratio. So how to adjust the capitals of the new partners when based on their new profit sharing ratio? If in the question, new profit sharing ratio is given, then no need to calculate new profit sharing ratio. If new profit sharing ratio is not given in the question, then you have to first find out their new profit sharing ratio. Afterwards, you have to calculate their capitals based on their new profit sharing ratio. So in this question, new profit sharing ratio of the partners is not given. Only new profit sharing ratio of Mr. Suresh only is given. New partners, new profit sharing ratio is given. So we have to calculate new profit sharing ratio of all the partners. That is the remaining partners, we have to calculate the new profit sharing ratio. So that you need to remember. If new profit sharing ratio is given in the question, no need to calculate. If it is not mentioned in the question, you have to calculate new profit sharing ratio. Now first we will prepare revaluation account. Now we will start from credit side. If at all any appreciation is there of an asset, we will write on the credit side. So once, before starting the problem, or I want all of you to have your textbooks in front of you. From new textbook, it is chapter number 5, page number 251, problem number 16. Page number 251, problem number 16. If you have textbooks, I want you all to have your books in front of you, children. If you don't have your textbooks, I want you people to have pen and paper and note down all the points or the amounts what I say, which we transfer to other accounts, so that it will be easy for you to understand. If you have textbook, it is well and good. Take your textbook, page number 251, problem number 16, capital adjustments topic. So if you see the adjustments, Suresh should bring rupees 20,000 as his capital in cash, depreciate furniture and stock by 10%. Land and buildings are to be appreciated by 20%. Land and buildings are to be appreciated by 20%. Whenever it is an appreciation, we will be writing on the credit side of the revaluation account. So by buildings account, what is the value of buildings? Buildings value is 20,000. So on 20,000, you have to calculate 20%. 20,000 into 20 by 100, how much? It comes to 4,000. 20,000 into 20 by 100, 20% on 20,000 comes to 4,000. So by buildings account, 4,000 rupees. Next, depreciation. We will... So only one appreciation is given in the adjustment. So we have written that on the credit side of the revaluation account, by buildings account, 4,000. Now you have depreciation. Depreciate furniture and stock by 10%. So two furniture, what is the value of furniture? It is 10,000. So furniture 10,000, on furniture, it is 10%. So 10,000 into 10 by 100, it comes to 1,000. So furniture depreciation is 1,000. So two furniture account, 1,000. Next, stock to be depreciated by 10%. So what is the value of stock? It is 15,000. So two stock account, 15,000 into 10 by 100. So on 15,000, you have to calculate 10%. So 15,000 into 10 by 100, it comes to 1,500. Those two stock account, it is 1,500. So two furniture account, 1,000. Two stock account, 1,500. Next, you have goodwill of the firm valued at rupees 8,000. Create a provision for bad debts at 5% on debtors. So whenever we need to create a provision on debtors, it should be written on the debit side of the revaluation account. Okay. So what is the value of debtors in the balance sheet? It is 20,000. So 20,000 into 5 by 100. Debtors is 20,000. 20,000 on 20,000, you have to calculate 5 by 100. That is 5%. 5 by 100, because in question it is given as 5%. Always provision or bad debts or provision for bad debts is always created on debtors only. So whatever loss we anticipate in the future, to overcome that, we create a provision. Okay. So provision is always created on debtors. So 20,000 into 5 by 100, it comes to 1,000. To provision for bad debts, it is 1,000. So buildings account, 4,000, furniture account 1,000, two stock account 1,500, two provision for bad debts 1,000. So all that, we have completed all the adjustments. Now see the totals. Our credit side total is more, 4,000 rupees. So we will write whichever total is more, we will write on both the sides the same value, 4,000, 4,000. Now what is the value of all the expenses? It comes to 3,500. 1,000 plus 1,500 plus 1,000 is equal to 3,500. So if our credit side total is more, then it is profit. The balancing figure will be profit. So profit is equal to 4,000 minus 3,500, that is equal to 500. So 500 is our profit. This 500 should be transferred to partners capital accounts, that is old partners capital accounts. Rajesh and Ramesh in their old profit sharing ratio. So their old profit sharing ratio is 3:1. So this 500 should be distributed among Rajesh and Ramesh in the ratio of 3:1. So Rajesh, 500 into 3 by 4. How we got this 3 by 4? 3 plus 1, how much? 4. That means out of 4 parts, 3 parts are given to Rajesh and 1 part is given to Ramesh. So 3 by 4. You have to add these two numbers and you have to divide. You will get a fraction. So 3 plus 1, 4. So 3 by 4, 1 by 4. So Rajesh share is 3 by 4. Ramesh share is 1 by 4. So 500 into 3 by 4, that will come to 375. So 375 rupees should be transferred to Rajesh capital account. So to Rajesh capital account, 375 rupees. 2 Rajesh capital account, 375 rupees. Sir, Ramesh, 500 into 1 by 4, that is equal to 125. So 125 should be transferred to Ramesh capital account. 2 Ramesh capital account, 125. 2 Ramesh capital account, 125. Okay, children. Now, this Rajesh capital account and Ramesh capital account, you have to make a note. From revaluation account, we will be transferring this amount to their capital accounts. Okay, 375 and 125. So, how we'll write general entries here? Revaluation account data to furniture account, 1000, 1000. Revaluation account data to stock account, 1500, 1500. Revaluation account data to provision for bad debts account, 1000 and 1000. Buildings account data to revaluation account, 4000, 4000. So, how profit should be credited to the partner's capital accounts? So, revaluation account data to Rajesh capital account, 375, 375. Revaluation account data to Ramesh capital account, 125 and 125. So from here, what you have to make a note? To Rajesh capital account, 375, and to Ramesh capital account, 125. So this is our revaluation account. Goodwill account. So here, when goodwill is created, it is to be credited to old partners capital accounts in their old profit sharing ratio. Okay. Old partners capital accounts in their old profit sharing ratio. Okay. So what will be the entry here? Goodwill account. What is the value of goodwill? It is 8,000 rupees. So it is given in the question of goodwill of the firm valued at rupees 8,000. So this 8,000 should be transferred to Rajesh and Ramesh capital account in their old profit sharing ratio. So, to Rajesh capital account, 8,000 into 3 by 4. How you got this 3 by 4? Their old profit sharing ratio is 3:1. 3 by 4 and 1 by 4. So, to Rajesh capital account, 8,000 into 3 by 4, that is equal to 6,000. And to Ramesh capital account, 8,000 into 1 by 4, that comes to 2,000 rupees. So, 8,000 is transferred to Rajesh and Ramesh capital account, or it is credited to their capital accounts in the ratio of 3:1. Okay. So what will be the entry here? Goodwill account data to Rajesh capital account, 6,000 rupees. Goodwill account data to Ramesh capital account, 2,000 rupees. Okay. By balance carried down. So whenever goodwill is created, okay, or for understanding the creation of goodwill, it is shown as an asset in the balance sheet. That is the reason we are writing by balance carried down. 8,000. Whenever goodwill is valued or created, it reflects in the balance sheet. Okay, we will be writing this amount in the balance sheet also. Goodwill, 8,000 rupees. Only when goodwill is created, then only goodwill will be appear in the balance sheet. Okay. So for understanding the creation of goodwill, it is shown as an asset in the balance sheet. Okay, children. So whenever goodwill is created or valued, you have to credit the partner's capital accounts in their old profit sharing ratio. Okay. So goodwill account, from goodwill account to Rajesh capital account and to Ramesh account, this will be again reflecting in capital accounts of Ramesh and Rajesh. General reserve account. General reserve account is given in the question of closing balance sheet. It is given as general reserve 10,000 rupees. So general reserve should be credited to old partners in their old profit sharing ratio. Okay, because this is a reserve they have kept aside. This amount belongs to old partners. That is the reason we are distributing this amount to old partners before admitting any partner. Okay. So general reserve also should be credited to old partners in their old profit sharing ratio. So what is the value of general reserve? It is 10,000 rupees. This 10,000 should be distributed to Rajesh capital account and Ramesh capital account in their old profit sharing ratio. So to Rajesh capital account, 10,000 into 3 by 4, that is 7,500. To Ramesh capital account, it is 10,000 into 1 by 4. It comes to 2,500. Total is 10,000. Okay. general reserve account by balance brought down 10,000. So this amount should be credited to old partners in their old profit sharing ratio. So to Rajesh capital account 7,500, to Ramesh capital account 2,500. So this amount also you need to make a note. So this amount also will be reflecting in their capital accounts. Now, our main topic today is adjusting partners' capital accounts based on their new profit sharing ratio. But new profit sharing ratio is not given in the question. So we need to calculate new profit sharing ratio. After calculating new profit sharing ratio, we will adjust their capitals on new profit sharing ratio, or we will calculate their capitals based on their new profit sharing ratio. So first we need to calculate their new profit sharing ratio. Here, to calculate new profit sharing ratio, what information we have? We know that new partner is admitted for 1/5 share in future profits. So new profit sharing ratio of new partner we know, and how much capital he is bringing we know. For 1/5 share in future profits, the new partner is bringing 20,000 as his capital. For 1/5 share in future profits, the new partner is bringing 20,000 as his capital. Now, first we will calculate the new profit sharing ratio. We know one partner's new profit sharing ratio. Then it is easy for us to calculate other partner's capital, new profit sharing ratio also. So we know that new profit sharing ratio of Suresh is 1/5. Okay. Now let us suppose the total profits as 1. So what will be the remaining ratio? What will be the remaining ratio? In session 1, we discussed all these examples, how to calculate new profit sharing ratio, children. This is the first example for calculating new profit sharing ratio. Only old partners, old profit sharing ratio is given. New partners, new profit sharing ratio is given. Then how to calculate new profit sharing ratio? We all know that new profit sharing ratio of Suresh is 1/5. So if we let us think that the total profits of the firm is 1. Out of 1, we have given 1/5 share to Suresh. We have given 1/5 share to Suresh. Then what is remaining? What is remaining? This remaining ratio should be distributed among old partners. Okay, in their old profit sharing ratio. So out of 1, whatever profit the new partner is sharing, if we subtract that, we get the remaining ratio. This remaining ratio should be distributed among the old partners. Then we will get the new profit sharing ratio. Okay. So remaining ratio is equal to 1 minus 1/5, that is equal to 4/5. So 4/5 will be our remaining ratio. Okay. We know their old ratio, it is 3:1. So this 3 is in this ratio, 3:1 ratio, this 4/5 should be distributed to old partners. Okay, then we will get the new profit sharing ratio. So new profit sharing ratio of Rajesh is equal to remaining ratio into old ratio. Remaining ratio into old ratio. You know now how we got this remaining ratio. If we think the total profits of the firm as 1, from that 1, if we subtract new partners new ratio, then you will be getting old ratio, that is 4/5. Okay. So, new profit sharing ratio of Rajesh is equal to remaining ratio into old ratio. That is 4/5 into 3/5, that is equal to 12/20. Still, we reduce the values, it comes to 3/5. So, new profit sharing ratio of Rajesh is equal to 3/5. Now, new profit sharing ratio of Ramesh. So, remaining ratio into old ratio. What is remaining ratio? 4/5. So 4/5 into 1/4 is equal to 4/20. If you still reduce the value, it comes to 1/5. So new profit sharing ratio of Ramesh is equal to 1/5. So new profit sharing ratio of Suresh is equal to 1/5. Already it is given in the question. Suresh, for 1/5 share in future profits, he should bring 20,000 as his capital. Already we have seen in the question. So new profit sharing ratio of Suresh is equal to 1/5. So, we know now the new profit sharing ratios of all the partners. So new profit sharing ratio of all the partners is 3 by 5 is to 1 by 5 is to 1 by 5. That is equal to 3 is to 1 is to 1. Okay. 3 is to 1 is to 1. That is 3 plus 1, 4. 4 plus 1, 5. So out of 5 parts, 3 parts are given to Rajesh. 1 part is given to Ramesh. And 1 part is given to Suresh. So 3 is to 1 is to 1 is a new profit sharing ratio of all the partners. Now we know the new profit sharing ratio of all the partners. Now we will see how to calculate the capital. Okay. How to calculate the capital based on their new profit sharing ratio. Okay. First we will see how to ascertain capital of the firm. First we will see how to ascertain the capital of the firm. If we know what is the capital of the firm, then we can distribute that to all the partners in their new profit sharing ratio. It becomes very easy. So first, ascertainment of total capital of the firm. How to ascertain the total capital of the firm? If we know one person's capital, then it is very easy for us to ascertain the total capital of the firm. We know the new partner's capital. For 1/5 share, his capital is 20,000 rupees. Okay. For 1/5 share of profit, the capital of the new partner is rupees 20,000. For 1/5 share, out of one, if for 1/5 share he is bringing 20,000, then for one, what is the capital? Okay. So that will be 20,000 into 5 by 1, that comes to 1 lakh. So the capital of the firm will be 1 lakh. How we got this 1 lakh? How we got this 20,000 into 5 by 1? See, for 1/5 share, for 1/5 share, for 1/5 share, the capital of the new partner is 20,000. For 1/5 share, the capital of the firm is, new partner is 20,000. Now, if it is 1, if we think the capital of the firm is 1, then what will be the capital of the firm? For 1/5 share, if it is 20,000, for 1, how much? You have to cross multiply. 1 into 20,000 divided by 1 by 5. So whenever you are dividing any fraction, what it becomes? It be reciprocal, no? 5 by 1. So if we want to multiply, it becomes 5 by 1. So 1 into 20,000, it is 20,000. 20,000 divided by 1 by 5. When we want to multiply, it becomes reciprocal. So 20,000 into 5 by 1. So 20,000 into 5 by 1. So total capital is equal to 20,000 into 5 by 1. That comes to 1 lakh. Excuse me. So total capital is equal to 1 lakh. So the firm's capital is 1 lakh. Out of 1 lakh, Suresh capital is 20,000. Now we will calculate partners capitals based on new profit sharing ratio. What is the new profit sharing ratio of the all the partners? It is 3 is to 1 is to 1. Just now we calculated. We have solved how to calculate this new profit sharing ratio. So new profit sharing ratio is equal to 3 is to 1 is to 1. Okay. So Rajesh capital is equal to, now we know the capital of all the firm, total capital. So out of 1 lakh, 20,000 is brought by new partner. So out of 1 lakh, what is Rajesh capital? So 1 lakh into 3 by 5. His new profit sharing ratio is 3 by 5. How we got this 3 by 5? 3 is to 1 is to 1. 3 plus 1, 4. 4 plus 1, 5. So 3 by 5. So 1 lakh into 3 by 5 is equal to 60,000. So 60,000 is Rajesh capital. Okay. For 3/5 share in future profits, for 3/5 share in future profits, Rajesh should bring 60,000 as capital. For 3/5 share in future profits, Rajesh should bring 60,000 as capital. Okay. Next, Ramesh. Ramesh, for 1 lakh, for 1/5 share in future profits, for 1/5 share in future profits, he should have 20,000 as his capital. He should have 20,000 as his capital. So, and Suresh capital, out of 1 lakh, he is bringing 20,000. Already we know, it is given in the question that Suresh for 1/5 share in future profits should bring 20,000 as capital. So, 60 plus 20, 80, 80 plus 20, 1 lakh. So, total capital of the firm is 1 lakh. Based on their new profit sharing ratio, Rajesh capital should be 60,000, Ramesh capital should be 20,000, and Suresh capital should be 20,000 based on their new profit sharing ratio. They should have capital as 60, 20, and 20. Now, we know their capitals. That means this should be in the opening balance sheet. Their capital should be 60, 20, and 20. Now we know. Now we have to adjust whether their capital is more or less. Now that we have to see. How we will know? By preparing capital accounts, we can know that. So, first, by balance brought down, what is their balance capitals, old capitals? That is Rajesh 30,000 and Ramesh 20,000. So, by balance brought down, 30,000 and 20,000. So, next, revaluation account. Profit we have seen now, how it is transferred to their capital accounts. So, by revaluation account, the amount what we have got in revaluation account, that amount we will be writing here. By revaluation account, 375, Rajesh profit, and Ramesh profit 125. Next, by goodwill account. So, goodwill is created. It is credited to their capital accounts in their old profit sharing ratio. Okay. So, that 8,000 is credited to Rajesh and Ramesh capital account in their old profit sharing ratio, that is 3:1, that we have seen in goodwill account. So, by goodwill account, 6,000 and 2,000. Next, you have general reserve. Even general reserve is also credited to old partners' capital accounts in their old profit sharing ratio. So, by general reserve account, 7,500 and 2,500. Next, by cash account, Suresh has brought goodwill in capital in cash now. So, that cash we will be writing by cash account, 20,000. Cash accounted are to capital account. So, to Suresh capital account. So, by cash account, 20,000 is Suresh capital. That also we will write. Next. It is children. Till now, what we used to do? We used to make the totals or balancing figure after adjusting all the adjustment to their capitals. The balance amount, whatever is there, is transferred to their capital accounts. Yes? But we write in their balance sheet. Whatever amount we balance carried down, we will be writing in the new balance sheet only that value. But here already we know that values. We have calculated now what should be their capitals based on their new profit sharing ratio. Based on their new profit sharing ratio, what should be their capitals? We have calculated already. Okay, how much we got? That is 60,000, 20,000 and 20,000. That is to balance carry down should be 60,000, 20,000 and 20,000. This amount already we calculated. This amount is based on their new profit sharing ratio. This should be their capitals. Okay, 60,000, 20,000 and 20,000. These amounts only we take in their opening balance sheet. Yes, 60,000, 20,000, 20,000. Now we will see whether the whatever amount after adjusting their balancing figures of in their balance sheet, in their capital accounts, whether they have deficit amount or they have excess amount, we will see. Okay, if they have excess amount, we have to refund them. If their balancing figure is less, that means after balancing, if their capital amount is less, then they have to bring the balance amount in cash. Okay, got my point? Now we will see. See, first we will start with Rajesh. Now after balancing Rajesh capital balance, after all the adjustments, what is his total amount? It is 43,875. That is 30,000 plus 375 plus 6,000 plus 7,500. After balancing all the adjustments, after doing all the adjustments and balancing his Rajesh capital account, what is the value we got? It is 43,875. But how much his capital should be? It should be 60,000. Okay. It should be 60,000. Okay. His share of capital for 3/5 share in future profits. Okay. In the future profits, what is his new profit sharing ratio? It is 3/5. So, for 3/5 share in future profits, his capital should be 60,000. But when we are doing balancing, after doing all adjustments, his capital is coming to only 43,875. Still, how much he should have? If we subtract from 16,125, 16,125 is shortage. Yes, it is less. That means still the Rajesh should bring 16,125 as capital. Okay. He should have 60,000. But after adjusting all his adjusting, after doing adjustments for his capital, what happened? He is getting capital as 43,875 only. That means how much is shortage? 16,125 is shortage. So Rajesh should bring in cash 16,125 to make his capital equal to rupees 60,000. To make his capital equal to rupees 60,000, Rajesh should bring 16,125 in cash. So by cash, we will write 16,125 in Rajesh account. Okay. Now we will see Ramesh. Ramesh, after doing capital, totals 20,000 plus 125 plus 2,000 plus 2,500. It is coming to 24,625. But how much capital he should have for 1/5 share in new future profits? For 1/5 share in future profits, Ramesh capital should be only 20,000. But after adjusting, after balancing, what we are getting? We are getting 24,625 is his capital. That means it is more, excess. He should have 20, but he is having 24,625. He is having excess amount. Then what we need to do? Whatever excess amount is there, we need to refund him. That means we need to give him back. We need to pay him back 4,625. Because already he invested more. He is having more. So he should have only 20,000 as capital. So whatever excess amount is there, that we need to refund Ramesh. Is it clear, children? Now we will see his total. Rajesh, out of 60,000, he is having only 43,875. How much is shortage? 16,125 is shortage. Okay. So by cash account, 16,125. Rajesh should bring 16,125 as in cash to make his capital equal to 60,000 rupees. Again, I am telling children, Rajesh should bring 16,125 rupees in cash as capital to make his capital equal to rupees 60,000. Is it clear? Because he is having shortage. How much amount is shortage? He should bring that much amount. Now, when it comes to Ramesh, Ramesh is having excess amount. Now we have to refund him. We have to pay him back. So to cash account, Ramesh, we will be paying 4,625. Okay. Ramesh will be paid 4,625. So we will be refunding Ramesh with 4,625. Okay. Suresh, already how much he is bringing in capital? 20,000 for 1/5 share in future profits. Okay, children. So here he is having deficit amount, less amount. So he will be bringing whatever is less, that amount, shortage amount, he will be bringing. Rajesh. Ramesh, he is having excess. He should have only 20,000, but he is having 24,625. So the balance amount we will be refunding him. Is it clear? So now their capitals have been adjusted according to their new profit sharing ratio. Okay. This is our main topic today. How to adjust partners' capital accounts based on their new profit sharing ratio. Based on their new profit sharing ratio, we have to calculate their capitals. Afterwards, after making all the adjustments, we should see whether their capital is equal to that amount or not. If it is not equal, we have to make it equal. Here, it is shortage. So, he will bring. Here, it is more. We will refund. If it is equal, no need to do any adjustment. Is it clear, children? Once again, go through, if you have any doubt, once again, you go through the slides, again, you go through the video and understand, children. This, by balance brought down, 60,000, 20,000, 20,000, this amount, it will be reflecting in the balance sheet, okay? 60,000, 20,000, 20,000. So these are the capitals based on their new profit sharing ratio. Okay. So same thing, whatever I explained here, you have in the theory form, like notes form. See, Rajesh capital balance of all adjustments is 43,875. Okay. Here we have seen 43,875. His share of capital for 3/5 share of profits for rupees 60,000. For 3/5 share of profit in future profits for rupees 60,000. But his capital is only 43,875. So there is a shortage of rupees 16,125. How we got this 16,125? Out of 60,000, if we subtract 43,875, it is 16,000 is shortage. Okay, so he brings cash rupees 16,125 to make his capital equal to rupees 60,000. Okay, this is about Rajesh. Now Ramesh capital balance is rupees 24,625 and required to contribute only 20,000. But his balance is 24,625. So he is having excess capital. So this capital should be refunded. So 4,625 will be refunded to Ramesh. Okay, children. Now we will see the cash account. We'll see cash account. Two balance brought on. What is the cash balance given in balance sheet, children? It is 35,000. Two balance brought down 35,000. So Suresh is bringing 20,000 in cash now. So to Suresh capital account 20,000, cash accounted out to capital account, because Suresh is bringing 20,000 as capital. So cash accounted out to capital account 20,000, 20,000. So 20,000 we are writing to Suresh capital account 20,000. Now after preparing the capital accounts, we know that Rajesh should bring 16,125. Whatever shortage amount is there, he should bring in cash. So cash accounted are to Rajesh capital account 16,125. So to Rajesh capital account 16,125. Okay, because Rajesh is bringing capital, whatever shortage amount is there, to make it equal to 60,000. Whatever shortage amount is there, that he should bring in cash. So 16,125. So debit what comes in, credit what goes out, no, cash account rule. So cash is coming, so we are writing on the debit side of the cash account. So to Suresh capital, he is bringing cash in capital. So capital in cash, so 20,000 we are debiting on in cash account. So this is cash brought by Suresh as capital. This is cash brought by Rajesh as capital, that is 16,128. And we know Ramesh is having excess capital. So we need to refund him. We need to pay him. That is, money is going out. So we are writing on the credit side. So by Ramesh capital account, 4,625. That is, we are refunding him. We are giving him whatever excess amount is there. We are refunding Ramesh. So by Ramesh capital account, 4,625. So by balance carried down, 66,500. The 66,500, you have to write this balance in the opening balance sheet, cash 66,500, not 35,000, because we have done so many adjustments for cash account. So the closing balance of cash account is 66,500. So this cash balance amount, we have to take it in the balance sheet. Now we'll see how to make this balance sheet of Rajesh, Amish and Suresh as on 1st April 2020. Okay, so keep your textbook, children. Look into your textbook. Closing balance sheet. First, we will start from creditors, that is liabilities. Creditors, what is the value given there? 40,000. So, no adjustment is there for creditors. So, we will take as it is creditors 40,000. And should we take general reserve? No, we should not take general reserve, because a general reserve already we credited to partners capital accounts. So, general reserve we will not show here in the balance sheet. Next, with their capitals, capital of Rajesh. Based on their new profit sharing ratio, what is the capital of Rajesh? It is 60,000. Based on the new profit sharing ratio, what is the capital of Ramesh? It is 20,000. And Suresh, we know for 1/5 share in future profits, he is bringing 20,000. So these are the capitals based on their new profit sharing ratio. We adjust accordingly. If it is shortage, we the partner brought in cash. If it is excess, the partner's cap amount is refunded. Okay. Now we will see on the asset side. Cash balance, how much amount we have to take? Whatever we have did this cash account, there 66,500. We have to take the same balance, that amount only, cash 66,500. Next, debtors. Any adjustment is there for debtors? Yes. Provision for bad debts is created. 5% on debtors. So that is 1,000. So less provision. 20,000 minus 1,000. Less provision. 20,000 minus 1,000. It comes to 19,000. Next, stock. Stock 15,000. For stock also we are having a adjustment. That is depreciation 10%. So less depreciation. 15,000 minus 1,500. That it comes to 13,500. Next you have land and buildings. Land and buildings is 20,000. Land and buildings value is appreciated by 20%. So add appreciation 4,000. So land and buildings value is 24,000. Next you have furniture. Furniture is 10,000. So furniture is depreciated by 10%. So less depreciation 1,000. So the closing, the opening value of furniture is now 9,000 rupees. So 10,000 minus 1,000, 9,000. So whenever goodwill is created or valued, for understanding of creation, what we should do? Goodwill, it is shown as an asset in the balance sheet. So goodwill also we need to take 8,000. Is it clear, children? Now when you tally, both assets and liabilities value should be equal. So 1,40,000, 1,40,000. Okay. Is it clear, children? Now, in this session, what we have learned? Adjustment of capitals based on new profit sharing ratio and how to treat goodwill when goodwill is raised or valued. Okay. And adjustment of capitals based on new profit sharing ratio. How to calculate their new capitals based on their new profit sharing ratio, that we have seen in this session. Other than that, we even learned how to prepare ledger accounts, that is revaluation account, cash account, goodwill account, general reserve account, capital account, and how to prepare balance sheet. From session 1 till now, what have we learned, children? Just I want to give an overview of whatever we discussed in all the 6 sessions. See, need for admission of a partner, why a new partner should be admitted, for capital, additional capital, or for their managerial skills to expand their business. Whenever the old partners want to expand their business, they admit a new partner for capital as well as for his managerial skills. Both they can get. They will get additional capital also, as well as they can use the managerial skills of the new partner. Okay. Then we have discussed the calculation of new profit sharing ratio, the different scenarios, how to calculate new profit sharing ratio. Okay, new profit sharing ratio, what is the formula? We have seen new remaining profit share into remaining ratio into old ratio. You will be getting new profit sharing ratio. And even we have discussed the calculation of sacrificing ratio. So how you will get the sacrificing ratio? Old profit sharing ratio minus new profit sharing ratio, you will get sacrificing ratio. Revaluation of assets and liabilities, in each and every session I have shown you the specimen of revaluation account. We revalue assets and liabilities so that the new partner, whoever is admitted into the business, will not gain or will not loss because of this admission. Okay, so we revalue all the assets and liabilities. If the asset value increases, we will write on the revaluation account credit side. If the asset value decreases, we will write on the debit side of the revaluation account. Vice versa with the liabilities. And we have seen even a specimen of all the revaluation account and the adjustment of accumulated profits, loss and reserves. If there is undistributed profit and loss, we have credited that to old partners in their old profit sharing ratio. Why we need to do that? Because this undistributed profit, it is kept aside from many years. So that belongs to old partners. That amount should be distributed to old partners only. Even accumulated profits also, to face the uncertainties which happen in the future, the partners have kept some amount as a reserve from the profits. So that amount also belongs to old partners. That also we have seen how to distribute or transfer to their capital accounts. So if at all it is given general reserve or profit and loss account in their closing balance sheet, then only we prepare that account. If not, it is not necessary. And even we discussed what is goodwill, what are the features of goodwill. Goodwill is nothing but it is the good reputation of the firm. So it's so many factors depends on the value of the goodwill, the size of the company, the scope, the nature, the business, their customer satisfaction, the relationship with everybody. Okay, everything, everything depends. And it is intangible asset. We cannot see, we cannot touch. Okay, it is inseparable from business. So that all we discussed in the previous sessions. And the valuation, methods of valuation of goodwill also we have seen. Average profit method, super profit method, and capitalization of profit method. All the methods, how to value. And the treatment of goodwill also we have seen, children. That is very, very important, treatment of goodwill. When goodwill is brought in cash, how to treat it? When goodwill is brought in cash and it is written off, then how to treat it? When goodwill is created or valued, today also the problem is based on goodwill created or valued, how to treat it? Then goodwill is created, valued and written off, then how to do the problem? We have seen. Okay, children? So whenever goodwill is created or a note, that is whenever goodwill is created or valued, then only it is it appears in the balance sheet as an asset. Okay. And now task for the day. Here a problem is given. This is problem number 17 from your textbook, page number 252, children. So once go through the problem, try to solve it. If you have any doubts, you can post in the comment section, children. Here, one step, it is easy. Already it is given in the question. New profit sharing ratio of XYZ is given in the question. That is 12 is to 8 is to 5. Already new profit sharing ratio is given in the question. So it is very easy for you people to calculate the capitals based on their new profit sharing ratio. Because Z should bring rupees 40,000 as capital. Already one partner's capital is given. So the remaining partner's capital, it is very. First to find out the firm's capital. Ascertain the firm's capital. Then it is very easy for you people to calculate the capitals of the remaining partners. Already new profit sharing ratio is given in the question. No need to calculate new profit sharing ratio. But in the previous, just now whatever we solved, the example, new profit sharing ratio is not given. So we calculated new profit sharing ratio. Then we ascertained the firm's capital. From that we ascertained the capitals of all the partners. Here one problem is solved for you. That is new profit sharing ratio is given. It only you should ascertain the firm's capital. From that, you have to ascertain partner's capital. That's it. Okay, children, try to solve the problem. Try to do more and more problems. If you have any doubts, you can ask your teacher or you can even post in the comment section, children. Thank you, one and all. Thank you. Special thanks to our principal ma'am for giving us for giving me this opportunity, for encouraging me also. And even special thanks to our subject coordinator, Mr. Riyazuddin sir, for giving me this opportunity and guiding me. Thank you. Thank you, one and all. Stay home, stay safe, stay productive and stay connected.
Thank you, madam, for the wonderful session. And thanks to all the students for watching this session. And one small message I want to give the students. A slogan is that practice makes man perfect. So believe in it. And I request all the students practice more and more problems from your new textbook or old textbooks. By that only you will get the confident on this subject. So please try to solve more problems from this unit. And finally, thanks to one and all for watching this session. Thank you, madam.
Thank you, sir.